right after us, we've got Women's World Cup Live. Rob Stone and the crew get you ready for a day of World Cup action. That's after us at 8 right here on FS1. They look so serious with the music. I'm sure they can't hear in the background. Back to the finals now. Kevin Durant is reportedly here in New York for further testing and evaluation of his Achilles. And according to Chris Haynes, KD was nowhere close to 100% before Monday's Game 5. See, you think the Warriors made a mistake clearing KD to play?
I know it's a mistake because I have the ability to be able to look and see what the results were. And I know that they can't prove it out, being that they did they do the right as far as rehab? They did. Did they do the right thing as far as we're going to try to get him some type of exercise? Yeah, they probably did. But then there's that next critical period, and it's called court time or field time. If you're a soccer player, football player, when can I get out in my position and do functional activity? They said he played a little bit of 3-on-3, a little bit of 2-on-2. Jalen Rose, good friend of mine, said, man, he saw the workout last week, and it did not go well. All along, I was concerned. I tore both my left and my right calf, and I was always concerned about tearing my Achilles. I said the morning of the game that I was concerned about Kevin Durant, not the calf, but the pressure point to that calf is that Achilles, that attachment point at the bottom of your heel. And when he went to grab that, that was frightening to me. So there's no way anyone in that organization wakes up today with a clear conscience and say, you know something? I'll swear on a stack of Bibles that if I could do this all over again, I would do the exact same thing. And I believe that because Toronto, they win critical game number 4, and the pressure, it started mounting. Not only outside pressure, but the professional pressure that we have as athletes, that I want to be out there with my teammates. I want to. And that right there, Kevin Durant succumbed to all those things, pushed himself out there, and we saw what happened. So there's no way no one in that organization is not sitting back and saying, you know something? I wish I had done it different. And I just believe this. If I put truth serum in Bob Myers, if I put it in his arm and put him in a chair and strapped him down.
Okay, this is graphic.
And he was, because he had a job before as an agent.
Yep.
And he represented a lot of powerful players, great players. And I don't think that he would have given Kevin Durant the same advice. If I'm his agent and I'm directing his career and he is less than a month from free agency. So what he did now in his job is totally different than what he would have done for his client in the last job, because his interest, his number one interest, is the organization. It is not those individual players. And that's where you get a lot of confusion when you're, does a player play or does a player sit?
But Nick, you're damned if you do and you're damned if you don't in KD's situation, are you not?
Well, he ended, for a guy who cares as much as KD appears to care about what is said and believed about him, he was boxed in at this point. And he was boxed in this regard, that you had guys like me saying for the better part of 3 years, he's a luxury, not a necessity. And I'm not being self-important when I throw myself into that. We've heard KD name check me specifically and others about that exact commentary. And then something every athlete, I would think, care about, what my teammates and coaches think about how hard I'm working to get back. You had all of a sudden a little leaky rumors and reports and sources that.
In that part, I don't believe to be true. I don't believe that the Warriors thought Kevin Durant could have played. I don't believe Clay. I don't believe Iggy. I don't believe Steph. I don't believe Draymond. I don't believe those players, Boogie Cousins. I don't believe any of those players thought that he could be on the court with the injury that he had. And that's the team right there. I could care less about the rest of the guys.
But when people hear Chris say, of course he shouldn't have played, and wonder if this is a hindsight being 2020, Chris for 30 days was saying Kevin Durant was not going to play again in these playoffs. Why? Because you are risking your Achilles tendon. Not because you could hurt the team defensively, not because the calf could get re-irritated. It's because of what you were worried about. And this is where the insight of, listen, I'm a math guy, I'm a numbers guy, I'm an analytics guy. We're seeing a lot of guys like me, some of them fresh off television, getting hired to front office jobs. Jalen Rose, in a different commentary, brought up with the New Yorker how problematic that is in the NBA, that they seem to be going away from the value of having played the game. Well, the value of having played the game, even though for you it was the NFL, not the NBA, was you've actually torn your calves. You actually felt the burning sensation in your Achilles and knew what Kevin Durant was going through there. So there is that element. And also, we have to tease this forward. The goal was not for Kevin Durant, when they cleared him, not for him to play game five. It's for him to play game five on that bad calf and weakened Achilles, and then play tomorrow on it, and then play Sunday. The goal was for Kevin Durant to play three games in 6 days.
I'm pretty certain I said that.
What?
He was not capable of doing that.
And the only reason you bring him back is because, well, you're facing elimination. You got to win that one, then win the next one, then
meaning
win the next one.
If the circumstances were different, there's no way the Warriors would have rushed him to get back.
I don't think so, and I don't think KD would have rushed himself if they were up 3-1.
So
if
why
it was
do you
2-2.
Think he rushed himself? Well, from external pressure?
I think it was all of the above. I think players want to play. I think he's a competitor. Mm-hmm. I think he loves basketball more than anything in the world.
Yes.
And I think he heard the voices. But when we say, did the Warriors make a mistake, it wasn't just in letting him play. It was the messaging of this whole thing. What's Joe Lacob doing last month in May saying Kevin Durant's going to play in the finals?
He will definitely, told Stephen A., he will definitely make appearance in the finals.
How the hell does he know? And he's the owner. Why did the Warriors, instead of just ruling him out indefinitely, slow drip this to where it was a constant storyline, to where all of those things, all of that led us to where we are right here today?
There's a constant theme in New England. That's why you never know about the injuries. A guy hurts his ankle, you don't know it's his ankle. He'll say lower extremity. So they made a lot of mistakes along the way. I just know that personally, that the interest of the organization, it always outweighs the interest of the player. And Kevin Durant, I hope he learned something from this. And Nick is my partner. But I'm just going to tell you, Kevin Durant, any other star out there, don't listen to people like him. You shouldn't give a damn. You shouldn't give a damn what they say. You're one of the best players at what you do. You are super special. Don't be listening to people because they don't know. You want me to tell you what they know? They know something about athlete's foot, rubbing their feet when they hurt. They don't know nothing about being an athlete. And Kevin Durant should listen to his body. He should get more in this whole thing. What he should get is a whole bucket of I don't give a damn about Nick Wright and other people who don't participate, because his body is his moneymaker. And his moneymaker took a tremendous hit. Now, I'm just going to tell you, as an athlete, I would have tried to play like Kevin Durant. I would have taken the responsibility that, no, it was me. It wasn't the doctor that pushed myself out there, and I believe that's one of the big differences.
And one of the reasons athletes pay their agents those commissions is not just to negotiate contracts, because KD doesn't have to negotiate contracts in the NBA. He gets a max contract wherever he goes. It's to protect you from yourself.
Stay in your ear.
And so this is where we criticize an agent named Rich Paul, a lot for advocating for his players too much. Rich Kleiman maybe should have advocated for his player a little bit more.
All right.